So now I would like to introduce to you the polar bear system. What is the polar bear system? First of all, I will have to tell you that I have developed a system, so to speak, a universal system, where I play the Dutch defense, for example, with black. And I have studied this system very closely, and I play all the different variations. And then I got the idea, why not use the ideas from the white side, as 180 degrees with reverse colors, you get the same type positions with one move more. And often this extra move really changes the evaluations of the positions. So it's more like playing some type positions that are complicated, because with black, Dutch defense is recognized as a dynamic defense, a good choice when you want to try to win. And then I say, why not try to play the Dutch defense with white and try to win? It's just as if we are being manipulated, that the first move, one, f2 to f4, is not a good move. But Ben Larsen, he said earlier in the 60s that f4 is just a normal move. It's not the best move, but it's just a normal move to start. And I think that we should just move on here, and then I will try to explain the different moves that black can do. Of course, if you want to play, for example, h6 or h5, then maybe you should first read some beginner books or get your school money back. But now let's continue with g7 to g6. Of course, now the bishop on f8 wants to go to g7. Now we can have many different variations, actually, and it's not a matter of being lazy with white here. Of course, we want to attack and get the initiative, and then we have to go into the center, for example, like here. Black can choose either to play c6, excuse me, c5, and then we have the Sicilian. Of course, white now can play knight c3, and we will then have the Grand Prix system in the Sicilian. And of course, sooner or later, he can also play g3, and then we will have the closed system in the Sicilian. And we must not forget that also d2 to d4 sometimes is possible, and then we will have the open system in the Sicilian. So there are many opportunities here. Of course, black can also play d7 to d6 right away, and then try to play the perk. And this is then also possible. And after d4, we will have the Austrian attack, a very complicated system, and black really has to know what he's doing. If this is too much theory for you, then I just want to show you another option. For example, just g2 to g3. But then you must be able to play the closed Sicilian or the Leningrad Dutch with reverse colors. And this is actually the main system that I'm going to teach later on in this teachings on my homepage. Then we have the Leningrad with the reverse colors. If after d7 to d6, then bishop g2, and then we will just continue with a slow system. And often it can be important to play slow system where you don't need to study that much theory, especially if you have work and children, family, and so on. Now the knight can go to c6 or d7, and after e5, then e4. This is not a well-known type position, but I have quite good results with this as white. And just because it's not known, it doesn't have to be bad, right? Then let's move on to the next move. And the next move is f5. Now, I think e4 is very interesting. Then we, so to speak, have a Fromm's gambit with reverse colors again. After f takes e4, d3, I think it's too dangerous to take on d3, winning this pawn. Because now, of course, white is threatening to win directly with queen h5 and checkmate. But a knight f6 doesn't really prevent white from building up an attacking position. Knight g5 can come later. Already after knight g5, white will have threats against h7. It's possible to play bishop takes h7 or knight takes h7 in combination with queen h5 check. Yeah, I would never play that myself. After knight f6, then it will just continue to variations we already have spoken about. For example, g6, g3, and we are then able to play the closed Sicilian or the Leningrad with reverse colors. Let's then move on to the e6 move. And here I would play knight f3. And after f5, for example, then e2 to e4. This is excellent gambit again, and it reminds us just of f5 as we saw. Knight g5, and if we protect the pawn, then d3, and we will have exactly the same. E takes d3 is just too dangerous. Now we have threats against h7, knight takes h7, bishop takes h7 in combination with queen h5, just as we saw.